the lesson before, you learned that group 1 metals are salt. So how can a group 1 metal be salt? Let me demonstrate to you using this group 1 metal, sodium. You see a piece of sodium. Now I try to cut it using a knife. You see? It can be cut so easily. Let me cut it again. Just like you are enjoying the steak. Okay? Next, I will add the sodium into a trough of water. Let's see what will happen. Can you hear the hissing sound? Can you see the sodium keeps moving? So the reaction is quite vigorous. Sodium is a reactive metal. Next, let's take a look at potassium. Potassium is another group 1 metal. Again, I try to cut the potassium into pieces. See if it is again soft. Oh, I even didn't need to apply any force. I just pressed the knife a little bit. Then the potassium was cut into pieces. Okay, next I'm going to put a piece of potassium into water. Let's see what happens. Wow. Anything different from the reaction before about sodium? So as you can see, after I put potassium into water, potassium burns with a lilac flame. So can you tell me which one is more reactive? Sodium or potassium? Which one? Of course, potassium. Both of them are reactive metals, but potassium can burn with a lilac flame. Sodium cannot. What do you think of water? Will there be any change about the water? Let me show you. This is red litmus paper. What is its function? Of course, it is used to test for the acidity or the alkalinity of a solution. Let's see how a piece of red litmus paper will change. What did you observe? The red litmus paper turns blue. What does it indicate? It is indicating that the water becomes alkaline. That's why the red litmus paper turns blue. Do you know what had happened? Is it a chemical reaction? Of course, yes. Do you want to learn more? If you study Form 4 chemistry, you will learn further how to write the chemical equation for the reaction involved. So let me, towards the end, show you what the chemical equation is about. Actually, using potassium as an example, potassium reacts with the water in the trough, and two products are produced. Potassium hydroxide. Hydrogen is a gas, and actually we cannot observe it so easily. But the fact that the solution turns alkaline is due to the formation of potassium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide solution is alkaline. That's why the red litmus paper turns blue. We can further write a chemical equation for the reaction involved. Let me show you how to do it. Potassium, we write K. Water, What's that? H2O. Potassium hydroxide. You did not learn it so far, I can tell you. Potassium hydroxide, KOH. And then, how about hydrogen? Hydrogen. H2. To make it a complete and balanced chemical equation, let me further show you. Actually, you need to add some coefficients. For the time being, I think it's not a time, good timing to discuss with you how and why I balance an equation like this. If you want to learn more, you can choose chemistry as the subject in Form 4 and you will learn more.